In this lecture, we're going to download the tools we're going to need in this course. We're going to download the Qt framework itself, and we're also going to download Qt Creator, the IDE we're going to be using. We're going to get our tools from this link here, so we're going to go there in our browser, and here we are. One might want to go directly to the Qt website and try to click on this download button, but they do take you through a number of steps that I'm not willing to go through right now. So let's go directly to the download page. Click on official releases here, and we click on Qt, and we are shown the versions that are available for Qt here. We're going to choose the latest version, which is at the moment 5.10. So we go in there and we choose 5.10.1. In here, we see a number of versions we can choose from. We see Qt versions for Windows. We can choose a Qt version for Linux and a Qt version for Mac. I am on a Windows machine right now. I'm going to choose this one, Qt Open Source Windows x86.5.10.1.executable. I click on it, and I am given this window to confirm that I want to download it. So I click Save File, and my download starts here. I already have the file downloaded to save time, so I'm going to cancel out of this. You should download it if you don't have Qt downloaded already. And I'm going to open the folder where I have it downloaded. I'm going to double click on it, and they tell you to open a Qt account and things like that. We're not going to go through this. Click Next. And right now we don't want to open a Qt account, so skip. Hit Next. And you are given an option to choose where you want to install Qt. Mine is going to be installed in C, Qt, Qt5.10.1. You can choose a location you like, or you can leave the default if that's okay with you. We're going to click Next. So I have installed this before, but you're not going to have this error, so I'm going to continue. On this screen, you can choose the tools that you want to install. We want to install Qt Creator, so we select it here under Tools. And we're going to install the Qt pre-built components for MinGW. I choose MinGW because it's a free compiler, so it's freely available anywhere on Windows, Mac, and Linux. And we're going to be using it. On Windows, you should also know that you can use Microsoft Visual Studio Compiler. We're not going to choose it here, but you can choose it if you have this IDE from Microsoft installed. We're going to hit Next. And we are given an option to accept the license or deny it. So we're going to accept, hit Next. And we're going to start our installation. You can click on Show Details here, and they're going to show you the progress of your install. Okay, our download is done right now, and you can see the result of our download. They say that Qt has been installed. They tell us the location where it is installed and where we can see the change log for that. Okay, so we hit Next. And we choose to launch Qt Creator, but let's not launch it right now. We're going to close this. I want you to see where it is installed and how to start it, just in case you have some doubts. So you click on Start here, and they show Qt Creator here, but we're not going to click that either. So we go down, we find Qt5.10.1, and we can click on it. You can see that I have Qt5.5 installed too. I have some projects that are using it, but you can have multiple versions of Qt installed, so you should know that too. So we're going to go in here, click on Qt Creator 4.5.1, and open it. Okay, here is Qt Creator opened, ready for you to use. If you look on the left here, we have a few tabs, and you can click around and see things. We're going to explain the UI of Qt Creator in an upcoming lecture. What we're going to do is create one graphical user interface project so that you see what Qt Creator is capable of. So hit File, New Project. We choose Qt Widgets Application. You have to choose where you want to put your project. In my case, I want to put it in the online courses course code and call it 1 2 Qt Creator demo. I hit next. I choose widget application. You don't have to, don't worry if you don't understand all of this. I'm going to explain this in upcoming lectures. For now, I just want you to be able to run something for the first time in Qt Creator. Hit next, next again, and finish. Okay, our project is generated, and this is what a Qt C++ project looks like. For now, you don't need to look at the code. All you have to do is click on this green button to run your project and make sure it works. You can click on this tab here, down compile output, to see the progress of how your application is being built. And you see that they say that the process of building our application exceeded normally. So we can see our app here. I know this is not very exciting, but for now, you know that your tools are working and we can start building our Qt applications. And we're going to learn the building blocks of how you do that in the reminder of this course. Okay, that's all I had to say in this lecture. You have Qt Creator installed. You run your first project. In the next lecture, we're going to look at the user interface of Qt Creator and try to explain it a little bit more. I'll see you there.